everybody, and welcome back to Broadway World's Next On Stage Dance Edition, sponsored by what? LaDuca Shoes. I'm your Broadway buddy, Ben Cameron. I'm your host for this incredible series, and it's a grand night for dancing, as far as I can tell. Now, moments ago, you saw clips of our top nine, and you're about to see even more from the contestants who have been voted forward into the top five as we reveal who's going to be moving on to week four of our competition. The contestants moving on to the next round received the most votes in our recent voting block, which opened on September 1st and ended just last evening at midnight, fresh, hot off the presses. You voted them into our top five, but now our judges are going to be able to watch and offer valuable feedback that they can apply into their performances for next week, which will then be voted on by the viewing public, aka y'all. The judges will also review at the end of the show performances that have barely missed that top five, are awesome almost, as we have come to lovingly call them. And our judges will be able to take one of our four awesome almost and push them forward into next week's competition. So the stakes are getting high. Speaking of high stakes, let's talk about our prize packages. The winner of the High School LaDuca Achievement Award for Excellence will receive a Broadway prize pack with merch from the Broadway World Store. They will receive a fresh, hot pair of the world's greatest dance shoe, LaDuca shoes, that come in either ladies or men's or what have you. They will also receive a $500 scholarship to the Steps on Broadway Summer Dance Program, and they will receive an $1,100, that's gone up from an original $1,000, thanks to the generosity of our friends at LaDuca, an $1,100 donation to the charity of their choice. We've gotten to hear some of those charities from these young high schoolers over the course of the last couple of weeks, and they're truly amazing organizations, and these are some very thoughtful dancers. Also, we're going to give away $200 and $100 scholarships to the STEP Summer Programs to our first and second runners-up as well. So we're very happy to be spreading the wealth around. Before we get started, though, with all of the fabulous dancing today, we're very excited to announce that Next On Stage Season 2 is now accepting submissions. That is our high school and college age singing competition. You're encouraged to submit your video to Broadway World Singing Competition as the second season begins next month, which, if you look at your calendar, which all of us do these days, is coming up very, very soon. All you got to do, head to broadwayworld.com/nextonstage, and you can submit your video and be the star you were destined to be. All right, friends, let's get to it and meet our incredible panel of judges. I've come to think of them as very good friends. They're very insightful and awfully pretty. Let's welcome to the screen Mr. Phil LaDuca.
Hello, sir. How are you, Ben?
I'm doing great. Okay, Phil, you see here, I've got a couple of your babies that are up for grabs for our winner. Now, I'm going to play Price is Right spokesmodel, and you're going to tell us what makes LaDuca Shoe, what has made them so serviceable and popular from every movie and Broadway show to professional dancers all over the world. Go for it.
Well, thank you, sir. That is the Alexis, and I'm proud to say that she's really very popular for us. And the fact that they are flexible, which Vanna will demonstrate here.
Yeah, Vanna's here. Thank
you. And then we have for the gentleman, the Luigi, which is a flexible jazz shoe. And so that
look at that, Phil. I have to tell you, when I received these, these didn't exist when I was treading the boards and dancing up a storm. No. And this, I've got to tell you, is remarkable.
Oh,
it looks so good and it's so supple. It's no wonder they're the hottest thing going.
Well, thank you, sir. I appreciate that.
Well, thank you so much. I've named them. Well, they already have names. Never mind. We also have incredible Sasha Hutchings from Hamilton, Oklahoma, everything you've ever seen. Hi, Sasha.
Hi, Ben. Nice to see you.
Good to see you too. You excited for this week?
Oh, I really am.
The stakes are getting higher. Do you have any feelings? Do you feel like you know who may have made it into the top five?
Oh, I have. I maybe have some private, quietly held hopes, but you know, I'm really excited to see how the votes went.
Okay.
I'm a big believer in voting. All right.
Absolutely. Yeah. Listen, if there's one thing we can say for the next few weeks is vote, vote, vote. Vote here, vote there, vote everywhere. And of course, Broadway's ultimate triple threat, who's been in 9,627 Broadway shows and counting, Tyler Haynes.
Hi.
Hi, Tyler. Tyler, what would you rock this shoe?
I would, I have, and I will continue to.
Absolutely.
And you know, Tyler, I love the Alexis too, so you know, good for everybody. Not really, it would be terrible in those, but I would try.
I don't mind telling you that I have on occasion, maybe after a couple cheeky glasses of wine, have tried on some of my gentleman friend's LaDuca shoes. There's a reason I wasn't in kinky boots. All right, Tyler, what are you looking for? Because they're dancing to songs from contemporary musicals today. What does that spark inside of you that you're looking for?
I mean, I think I'm excited. I'm always excited to see what they bring to the table and see how they elevate their performance from the previous week. And I think that's the main thing. Just I want to see how they interpret this theme and you know, to see how. I don't know. I'm just excited.
You're chomping at the proverbial bit. All right. As I mentioned, this week we have given our dancers the theme of dancing from a contemporary musical. And we'll be hearing some familiar tunes tonight, that's for sure. Some well-loved contemporary songs. We'll be showing shortened clips of each of the performances from the dancers in our top five. But if you want to see all of anyone's full performance, all you got to do, head to BroadwayWorld.com/nextonstagedance, and you can watch the whole thing. Let's jump to it with bated breath. Here are our top five. First up, Serenity Holmes. We welcome back Serenity Holmes. She's dancing to Getting Married Today from Company. I love that. This week, and we've been talking a lot about this, judges, this week and last week's performances were indeed self-choreographed.
Oh,
no way.
Yeah, so good call there. Take it away, Serenity Holmes. Serenity Holmes. I love it. I feel like Serenity is definitely thinking outside the box here. I did not see a number from Company coming in today. and I got to give Serenity some points for using the Madeline Kahn recording of Not Getting Married with a live audience. Very exciting. All right, let's start with Sasha. What did you think of that?
Oh, so fun. You took so many things, from last week, and I got to see some different aspects of you that I've been really waiting to see. I love the groundedness. I love the movement. I felt like you really tapped into a lot of comedy and character. And then you still had these like technical elements, which I really loved. It was really, really fun to see you do that. So much story, so much character. Really, really great. Keep going in that direction. My challenge would be, even in those technical elements, to really connect those to character. I feel like the grounded, like more, I don't know any other word for it, but very interesting like sense of movement that you have. I felt like we're very like motivated, and I just want to see like one that struck me was like a big leap. What do you call this, Tyler? Like Antonin? I don't know.
Calypso.
Or that. Yeah. Well, like, and I didn't know what that was. Like, why you did it, and that. That, and as we push you, I think that's going to become more and more important for you, because other things were so dropped in and your face was so present. We got to see you. I really great work.
Yeah. What did you think, Calypso Haynes?
Calypso Haynes. I don't know. That's what we called it back in competition days back long ago. So I'm sure there's like a correct term, but
they go by many names.
Yeah. I thought you really stepped up your game this week, big time.
Yeah.
You've been listening to our notes. I love that you, like Ben said, thought outside of the box and were able to tap into a different side of your personality and your movement and your storytelling. I completely agree with Sasha because that was a moment to me that stood out as I want you to, your next challenge now is your threading within your choreography, putting it all together, threading it all together so it all makes sense instead of like, and your stuff this week, you trusted, there were just the fact like you trusted your movement and the choreography and what the song was doing and you didn't like dance too hard. But with that being said, then when you have those moments, like Sasha was saying, they have to be threaded with the other moments so they don't stand out as like you're on your knees and then all of a sudden you're doing a big leap and you know, so just really focus on the threading. But really, really great job. Great job.
I love that idea of threading for sure. Mr. LaDuca, what were your thoughts there?
Well, let me step in and play academic here. I will say that would be a grand renversé en tournant.
That's what I was.
I failed you.
But Serenity, you know, we adore you. We have, you have stuck out to us for all these weeks. And please know that we love you. And I'm going to be, I'm not harsh, but I'm going to really be nitpicky because you are good. And because that's the whole point, really. Winning awards are wonderful. I don't know about Sasha and Tyler, but I never won awards and made it to Broadway. So it's what you learn along the way and how it improves you that is what is important from this. So the most important thing is the learning aspect from this. What I saw was more geared toward dancing in a studio and a competition kind of mentality, as opposed to realizing that if you did this on a Broadway stage or a stage, it doesn't have to be on Broadway, but that you would have to play it differently. And I thought you played it more internally, which is fine, but you have to internalize while you're also presenting it in a proscenium setting, meaning more so that the technique, again, fabulous, wonderful, don't worry about it. You're there with it. I wanted to see you push it more in regard to the character going a little flipper, crazoid there, and losing it and coming back. And especially when you've got someone like Madeline Kahn, who is just a master of pulling that. I've got it together. Whoa, I just lost it. And those acting moments, as we keep talking about, is what Sasha and Tyler keep saying. Keep pushing that envelope and don't worry about the technique. It's there. It shows. We think you're fabulous and keep going.
I love that. And it's important. We are going to nitpick at this stage of the game. We're talking top five here out of hundreds and hundreds of submissions. This is big stuff. So I think that's really appreciated. I thought that was, I'm going to go ahead and say it because I'm not a judge, make that very clear, but that was my favorite of Serenity's performances so far. Yeah. I think I'm definitely seeing the growth as well. All right. Also in our top five, it's Tristan Hill. Tristan will be dancing to Why God Why from Miss Saigon this week. Tristan's performance also self-choreographed. Show us those moves, Tristan. All right, that's Tristan Hill. I think Tristan is dancing like it is indeed the last night of the world. keep up if you can. It's a theater geek, river runs deep within me. Mr. LaDuca, what do you think of Tristan's performance? Pretty heartfelt.
Lovely. Wonderful to see. Again, technique is fabulous. The undulations and the control of your body, how you're able to flow and bend and really articulate is really pleasure to watch, Tristan, really more so. Again, too, I'm playing the heavy this week because we're getting down to number five, so I'm really putting you to the wall with things, literally, like you did in the back, which was great, using that wall and sliding down. Couple of things, because the camera was coming in and out with you, I wanted to see more eye contact. I wanted to see your face. I wanted to see you connect. You were doing a great job of internalizing of what this was meaning to you, and that really showed through your body. Lost it several times in the face. Wanted to see you actually that emoting coming from the face so we connect more with you. I think really that is really a small part of to improve upon what you're doing. Keep going. Also, one other thing, please. Work on smoothing out those transitions so we don't see you setting up for a trick. We don't want to see you set up for that trick. Let it just, boom, come out of nothing. Very small little things, because it was an incredible job. Good job.
Yeah, I love that song now and forever. Sasha Hutchings, what are your thoughts?
Really lovely. I'm enjoying to see these different sort of tones and textures of Tyler. I like it. No, it's not, his name's not Tyler. His name's Tristan.
Well, I'll take it.
But Tyler's got wonderful textures as well.
He does. I was really, sorry, y'all. Anyway, what I want to say, Tristan, is I'm really loving to see these tones and textures. I think I really enjoy, like, you have like a really interesting internal quality of movement that I love to play with these like contractions, and we're talking about undulations and this tension. There's so much juice in there, and there's so much story in there. And I think as you mature as a dancer, there is like this style of like competition and stuff that is a little, it gets away from the humanity of the actor and the dancer. And I kind of want you to play, sometimes there were reaches that were too strong and too straight, or there were shapes that were, I just wanted, because you were tapping into this very like human, like longing and frustration, I wanted to see a little bit more, less dance, less like, I think some of what Phil is talking about with the transitions, I just got a little in that. I think you can pull back. This one, I kind of wanted to just see you be a person more than anything else. And I think you are an actor, because, and I saw that last week as well. So I think you can really lean a lot more into that. And one place I'm gonna say that I think will help make this like a thing that you can grab onto is when you went into the dance position, I thought that was really like a great choice and really smart and powerful, because anytime you can choose something that is identifiable to the average person, that like they're like, well, I know what that is, you really loop it, you really pull in your audience. So when you go to do that, it was very like here, which is not how we dance. If I'm gonna grab somebody's hand, it's here. And you're grabbing, do you have her hand on her back or her waist? Is she close to you? Like, or is it far, is it formal? So really think about those things, and don't let it, we don't need the idea of it. You don't have to play with it, do it. Like feel it, be in that moment and do it as the actor. And then you will dance, you are a dancer. So tap into that story as an actor. And I think that that will help those reaches and those things, where are they coming from rather than where they end up. Really thinking about your motivation, because that was really, I thought it was really beautiful. And also I like that you're playing with the turns, and I like that you're making different choices. And I think you have to keep doing that for yourself. It's a skill you have. Like, honestly, if I could do it, I'd probably do it all day long too. So, but playing with how it ends, how does it start? What's the shape that you're in? Keep playing with that and keep pushing and find new interesting things with it.
Love it. Tyler.
All right. So I agree with everything they're saying. First of all, I love that you chose that song. But with that being said, that song is so, there's so much story in that song, the whole song, and you picked the climax of it. And so the thing I'm gonna zero in on is exactly what my other two cohorts have been talking about, and that's the acting of it. For me, it was lacking the connection that I wanted, because I just didn't know what, I think for you, and you're an amazing dancer and you are a great storyteller with your body, but with some, now we're really, really wanting more of the acting, and that's where you have to do the work on your own. It's like, you know, going back to the top of the song, it's like knowing what's happening, and not that you have to be like, I'm playing Chris in Miss Saigon. That's not what I'm saying. It's just the song keeps building because he's not only like in this foreign place with this foreign girl, but it's just like, it's this, he's so confused. He's so conflicted. And I was missing that. That's what I was missing. We're getting nitpicky. I know, dude, I know. But like, that's where you go to the next level, is it's not about the dancing, it's about the acting. And I really want you to just keep moving forward with that and keep doing the work. You do the work on it, so then when you perform it, you throw it away and it's just there and we can see it, like Sasha was saying. You know, that at the top of it, he's like, why does she smell of orange trees? All these things. There's so many amazing like visualizations that are in the song prior to that. I want you to do your homework as an actor now, so then we just see it, because especially with the camera and it's right here, or if it's right here, whatever, we should be able to see it in your eyes. And that's what Phil was talking about. We saw it in your body, but we really got to see it. You're living this moment. But that's like I said, we're just being really nitpicky because it's getting down to the wire. But I thought this was another huge jump from last week. Huge jump. And it was a bigger jump from the first week. And now, you know, I'm so excited to see what you do now. What's next week, you know? But we're just going to keep pushing you in that direction. But good work. Really good work.
I love it. I feel like we're really getting to see them be sponges. Yes, Sasha.
I want to add on to what you're saying, because I'm thinking back to the pieces we've seen. And I do. I think you're an incredible dancer. And I think you're an incredible actor. And I saw that last week with the face. Like I was like, oh, he's got, there is story. I think last week's song, Almost Like Being in Love, is about somebody on top of the world because they're in love. You have an ability to play confidence very well. And I think that that goes with your technique and the efficiency of your body very well. Like when you're playing, when it's about somebody on top of the world, going after what they want and getting it. But I think when I think of my shot and I think of this number about people in conflict or people not yet there, people in very complex, confusing situations, and there's a cockiness, but there's a grittiness, or in my shot, there's more grit. I was like, I want more struggle, I want more grit. And with this one, there's this internal thing. I think that's just something for you to maybe notice about yourself, about what you naturally embody when you walk into a room. And none of us have a ton of control over that. You know, like we are who we are. We sometimes people perceive us one way and perceive us another, but knowing that about you and how your body communicates and how you're, who your person, your aura sort of, I think will help. Maybe there's different ways in for you with these other story types, because I think last week I was like, oh, he's right on top of it. But it's about this guy who's on top of the world. And I think you come off that way for a number of reasons when you perform. And so with stories like this, you just got to dig a little deeper or find another way in with your body, with your technique, and then with your acting and your story. How do you communicate struggle? And it's harder because it's more vulnerable, and it's a harder thing to tap into, but just something I've noticed and I think would be a good thing to mull over as an artist.
Oh, we love performers that are willing to shake it down and be that vulnerable. I love all of that. All right. Awesome. Well done, Tristan. Also in the top five, Becca Perrin is in the top five, dancing to the Pinstripes Are All That They See from Catch Me If You Can. This is another self-choreographed performance coming from Becca. Take it away. All right. I was fully enthralled there. Yeah. I think that we all agree that Becca is our reigning queen of the Hinge. And we love that about Becca. Tyler, talk to me.
Well, first off, the whole get up, I was like into of just like a well-made leotard and tights and heels. So great job. Becca, good work. Good work this week. I loved the choreography. There was for me, it just I as far as I don't know, it was interesting because there was a relationship with the camera, but I just wanted something a little more this week, just as far as like the storytelling of it. That's just me. Your lines are great. Your subtlety is great. I just think I just wanted a little more in terms of your point of view. But good work, really good work.
Great. Yeah, great style, I thought. What did you think, Phil?
Style, thank you, Ben. A good lead-in for that was what I saw, Becca, which we see every week. But again, too, your intelligence of moving, so you're not doing the same steps to a different song, which we see a lot of. So the intelligence of doing your homework and seeing the stylized, which, of course, what I saw there was very Luigi Matt Maddox 60s, actually post Jack Cole. So, but it's still, it's set in the 60s, this piece with the storyline. What I wanted to see more, jumping on what Tyler is saying, is we understand, and it's sometimes we have to pull ourselves back and realize that you're very young. This is high school level right now. And sometimes really at this age, your well is not as full because you haven't lived a lifetime yet. You have a fabulous life ahead of you. And there's a well that we draw on as performers, and that when you enter into acting classes, when you do emotional contact exercises and they ask you to go back and think about things in your life, and they pull things from you from traumatic experiences. And so in this character, I saw a slinky, seductive, getting the kind of the whole thing about this storyline is this person getting away with things and manipulating. And that's what I wanted to see more of that pulling you in, because I'm going to reel you in. I'm going to hook you. I'm going to catch you. And then I'm just going to dangle you how I like. I think of Rochelle Rack, who did this show. Rochelle is a master of that. Now I've got you in my clutches. So again, I understand that this is something that is outside of your comfort zone, and we applaud you for it. And we want you to keep pushing it towards that avenue, because your technique, your intelligence is really showing. And again, we're being very picky with you because we see wonderful things, and we will continue to see wonderful things.
I think we will. And I love a shout out for Rochelle Rack, master of subtlety and nuance.
Off of her own shoe at Laduca.
Absolutely. Get it now. Sasha Hutchings, what are your thoughts?
I think Phil said everything. I think there's just a maturity that it comes with time, and it's sort of this like double-edged thing where, like, as you mature, you have more understanding of the movement and less ability to do it, to pull it off. But you have an incredible facility. You have an incredible brain and a maturity that, again, makes us forget how young you are. And I enjoy your lines are beautiful, your fluidity. Honestly, this is such a technical thing, but I wanted the track to be over the video because yeah. I feel like the sound was muted and so much of this is music. And that's just a function of like, you know, that's not you, that's tech. But you, and then I was like, but she's so quiet in these heels. Like she's like really soft into this thing. So I think you're an incredible dancer and I did want more. But I don't know if, you know, what the music or had to do with that or just, or I've enjoyed seeing your growth process and I'm really excited to see where you go. You are an incredible dancer. Learn. Yeah. I hope you sing. You better sing.
You better sing.
Not a lot together because you have a long career ahead of you.
I agree with that 100%.
You're gonna go be a doctor or something. I don't know.
Well, you could be a dancing doctor.
Yeah,
absolutely. It's time for the dancing doctor, Dr. Perrin. All right. Two more in our top five. In the top five is Hannah Lieberoff, who will be dancing to "I'm Breaking Down" from Falsettos. Take it away, Hannah Lieberoff. All right. Once again, I'm very thinking outside of the box. I don't know that I've ever seen a competitive dancer use that song, and I'm glad that we're seeing that. What do you think, Phil?
I love the choice. Yes.
Yeah.
Definitely stretching things. And when I heard falsettos, oh, okay. Again, we love you. You're one of our favorites. Full of energy. Just has this rubber face that just gives us so much. Again, please remember that we're being harder because that's what it's all about. You need to strike the iron while it's hot to mold it, to get it to shape. So take these critiques for the how they're being presented and meant to you because you've gotten to this level because you're good. Now, what I wanted to see instead of a tumbling run, I had the wonderful opportunity of dancing with Twyla Tharp, and she was nuts. And you never knew what to expect from her. You'd literally be in the rehearsal room and she'd come running at you in the last second and yell, and you'd have to turn and catch her. And she'd say, "Now slide me down." And it just was wacko. And I thought, I saw it too controlled. I saw it choreographed instead of somebody going crazy. I would suggest go back and look at Twyla's stuff like Pineapple Pole and Push Comes to Shove. Just the wacko craziness of it, yet it was dance. And that's what made her so incredible was that she took spontaneous movements that came from out of nowhere except wackoness that fit into a musicality rather than imposing choreography on it. Because we know you're a wonderful little actress, now take it into a different realm.
Great, all right, Tyler.
I completely agree. The thing I liked about your piece this week is you didn't steer too far off from like your aesthetic, but there was more of a truth in it that I liked. Maybe it's just because it was still, you know, comedy, but it was a little more, I feel like, I don't know, we just saw there was a desperation in it, which I really liked. And also I agree with Phil. I liked this choreography a lot. The thing that took me out of it was the tumbling pass a little bit, but that's just because the part right before it, like you were with the chair and then you started doing this stuff and then you run. And what I was like wanting is if you're gonna run into that pass, run like a maniac into it and do it. and then reverse right after you land to being subtle, because that's what happens in the song. So it's just looking at those beats and not, I don't know, they've got to be a little more thought out in full. And with something like this, I thought this was a great piece for you. Like Phil said, we're going to say to everybody, it's just we're getting nitpicky, but it's what, you know, just kind of like when you look at choreography like you have to, it's just like doing a monologue. It's all these things. You've just got to have every moment thought out, because in life, you know, or you know, a reason why you don't, you know, this character is all over the place. The song's all over the place. So like really fill those moments, if that makes sense. I'm rambling, but Sasha.
I was right there with you, Tyler. I was just listening. I think, okay, so I guess one of the things I want to start to note is that we are commenting a lot on choreography, and a lot of you have self-choreographed, which is really great. And so while you were talking, I was like, yeah, like where is that line between the choreography and the performance, or the choreography and the dancing? Because we're not always the one choreographing. And sometimes you are, and sometimes that's a blessing, and sometimes it's a curse. Like sometimes it's like, you know, you can't see yourself, or how do you structure the thing? I really enjoyed this from you. I thought it was like a great way to stay in what you feel you do really well and find a different sort of piece of music or a little bit of a different story to go along that route. I do think it's the ups. If I'm talking about your performance, because we've definitely talked about the structure of the choreography, which I think is great. I think it's the ups and downs and just the clarity of it, of like what moment, what point of a breakdown are you at? And maybe being able to choose like how to illustrate those things, you know, the subtle to the crazy, to the rage, to the sad, to all those things, and really, really nailing down when those moments happen so that, you know, that the motivation of this like, I don't know, like losing your mind is clear, that we see like, oh, these are all the, you know, the stages of grief, or like, you know, the denial, the sadness, the anger, all the things that we get to see, and that you do that through your body. And then these are such nitpicky things. You're great. The hair was getting to me because I felt like it needed to be used. I felt like it was useful, but then sometimes I felt like it was like in your face and I couldn't see the story, because then it was here. And so much of you are such an expressive person. And I'm not going to tell you how to do your hair other than just to really be conscious that it's an effective tool that you have, but you have to use it in the correct way, as with everything else, because I think I got a little like, it felt like everything else where I was just like, where are we going in this breakdown? Like, is it the hair in the face is one thing, get it out of there, and the other, like, are you trying to clear your mind? Like all those things can really specific moments go a long way. I was like, she tumbles, my God, you know? And again, I love it. I just wanted to see you work it in. I wanted to see it come out of one thing and, like Tyler said, go into another and feel just like, feel like a freak out, which like I'm like, I don't know, can she run like this? Like, don't you need to prep for those things? Like, I don't know if you can run like that to go into a tumbling bath.
If anybody can, though, I bet it's her.
But you know what? You'll figure it out. And then like, how do you come out of it? All of those things, the same thing we've talked about with turns and all those technical elements. It's really about making it going all the way to the end of like, how technical can you get? How complex and like, you know, advanced can you get? And then how do you bring that back to something so human? It feels like I've done that before, you know. So, great work.
That relatability. I just like that the high schoolers are really tackling mental breakdowns in their choices of contemporary musical theater.
Them. They're like, you know, learning, remote learning, and like, what is the world? And we don't know what to do. So they're like, well, crap. Like,
absolutely. Mental breakdown feels right on time, I think.
That tracks.
It does. It tracks. That scans. All right. One more person in our top five before we get to our awesome almost. And that person is Candace Anselm. In the top five, Dancing to I Know Where I've Been from Hairspray. Her performance was choreographed by Tara Michelle Kennedy. Welcome back in our top five, Candace Anselm.
There's a road we've been traveling, lost so many. Oh.
Taking it to the streets, Candace, and giving us full NBC Live moment. Let's talk about it. Sasha Hutchings.
Thank you. Yeah, it's been a tough week. It's been a tough year, and I'm just I'm grateful for you using your body and your voice in that way and to tell that story. And I think you're technically incredible. I don't even know where to go with this because I'm in the midst of coping with, you know, things like the Breonna Taylor decision was handed down yesterday, and I'm disappointed in it. So I think what I want to say to you is just I see you, and I'm proud of you, and go further, do more. You are a beautiful dancer by anyone's standards. And I think as Black dancers, sometimes fitting your body into an aesthetic that is not made for you, was not created on you, can be hard. And I wanna encourage you to explore more of your body because I think there's more story there. And I saw a lot of like technical things like, you know, fouettés and all these things. And in this, like go in, do what you need to do to get out this story. Cause that's what we have done for, and Black dance has been forever, is storytelling. So that is I thank you for that. And my critique is to do more and let go. You have all the permission to let go of the pretty things and really dig into the depth of what those stories are. So thank you.
I love that. I think that's, we just kind of witnessed the power of performance and bearing your soul and how it can affect others who get to watch that. I love that. Tyler Haynes.
Yeah, I totally agree. You elevated this assignment and used your voice in a way that was so powerful. And it also each week, you know, you've really, you know, met the bar with what we've given you. And this week it just was, you know, you just elevated it. And I agree with Sasha. I'm just like, go deeper. And now it's kind of like with your movement now, just kind of let go of maybe the control with it. You know, and just like, because if this is nitpicky, but you're a beautiful dancer. You're a beautiful dancer. And also you're so like, there was it's such an expressive quality in this piece this week that translated through your movement. And I just now want to see you like mess it up a little, if that makes sense, or let go of some control with it. But like, this was gorgeous. Great work.
Great. Phil.
Couldn't concur with my colleagues more. I am going to dub you the Junior Miss Misty Copeland. Yeah. The technique was fabulous. loved your layout. Really incredible. I loved you were doing it in combat boots.
Yeah.
You were doing technical dancing at the highest level in combat boots and didn't miss a beat. A lot of people, we would have noticed the uncomfortableness, the insecurity. You were rock solid. The biggest thing that I can say, well, a couple of things, because it was so incredible. I wish I had a scorecard. I would say 9.9, because I never give a 10, because there is no such thing as perfect, because it's always practice, not perfect. We're always going for perfection. It was so close. What excited me about it was that we look at dancers and we judge what they are doing and give them critique as to move on. What you did for me watching this was you challenged me. You challenged me as a choreographer, as a director, as a cinematographer to say, wow, how can I make that performance better? Not you, how can I make that performance better for you? Couple of things, three things right off that I can think of. The very first thing, incredible setting, really smart choice, that setting, that back alley. But you stayed right in the center of that and you didn't use that environment. That camera followed you. It would have been great for you to be up on one of those stairwells and do a little tour jeté off of it. Then that one moment at the end when you did that big contraction, I wanted it to be, because I saw the production value so great, I wanted it to be where you were hooked up to a harness and got pulled, just pulled you so far back. And the last thing was, I wanted a couple of crates next to that garbage can. I said, she's going to do it. She's getting close to that garbage can, the dumpster. I thought, if you would have done a couple of jump ups onto that and gotten onto that garbage can and let it rock and come down onto that garbage can at the end, the audience would have been standing up applauding, ovation. That's how much that number moved me.
I love that. More of the idea of using our surroundings. All right, guys, judges, people watching at home, that's your top five, but we're not done yet. So congratulations to our top five. You're going to want to make sure you keep an eye on your emails to figure out, get the information regarding next week's round of competition. Congratulations to our awesome top five. When we come back, the judges will take a look at four performers who were this close to being in our top five, and they're going to get the chance to save only one of them and push them forward in the competition. So come right back. All right. We are back. All right. Four dancers who came close to make the top five. And you're going to save one of them and put them forward into the competition as we move on to week four. All of the dancers who didn't make the top five will be performing. No judges' critiques this time for our viewers. They're going to have to deliberate and figure out who they want to push through. Let's get right to it. Let's take a look at what Sarah Zampella has for us. Dancing to All Falls Down from Chaplin, another self-choreographed routine. Take it away, Sarah.
Think I'm rather small, 'cause the posh papers are falling at your feet. So go ahead and snub me, and don't return my call, and build your house on top of Easy Street. And what you're gonna do when it all falls down, and where you're gonna go from there? What you're gonna do when the money's gone, and who you're gonna buy to care? what you're gonna do when the country says, now get yourself out of here. What you're gonna paint when you cannot paint the town? I'm gonna wipe the smile from that famous little clown. And what you're gonna do when it all falls down? And all the king's horses and all the king's men
Sarah Zampella.
Yeah.
And let's shout out to the incredible I always forgot her name, and I was just about to say Yankalella. Yeah.
She sings the crap out of that song.
What?
She sings the crap out of that song.
Seriously. Hot diggity dog. All right. Yeah, she's a rock star, that's for sure. Okay, let's take a look at Ricardo Tjongson dancing to the Land of Lola from Kinky Boots.
Leave expectations at the door. Just let your eyes explore my cinematic flair. From my boot to derriere, I've got a lacy, silken feel with arms as hard as steel. I am freedom, I'm constriction, a potpourri of contradiction. Leave that humdrum face of plum behind. Once you walk inside these doors, you're mine. Now let me blow your mind and light your fire. And bam, here I am. Yes, ma'am, I'm Lola. And like you say, ooh-wee, that's me, Ebony. I am Lola. Ooh. Step into a dream where glamour is extreme. Welcome to my fantasy. We give good epiphany. So come and take my hand. Come to the line, oh Lola, oh Lola. At that Ginger Rogers telephone, with the moves of Fred Astaire. I'm Black Jesus, I'm Black Mary, but this Mary's legs are hairy. I'm your cocoa butter bitch, not this cookie cutter kitsch. I provide the unexpected, with a prize that's undetected.
Ricardo Tjongson rocking some very kinky boots right there. Next up in her awesome almost, Catherine Zimmer dancing to You Matter to Me from Waitress with choreography by Jessica Altshuler. Take it away, Catherine. That's Catherine Zimmer giving us some Waitress emotion. And rounding us out, Ava Madara dancing to An American in Paris from An American in Paris.
Thank you.
Ava Madara, American in Paris right there. All right, everyone, when we come back, our judges will let us know who's moving on in the competition. Come on back. All right, we are back, and it is the moment of truth. Our judges have had some difficult conversations about who they are moving forward. And we will leave it to Phil LaDuca to let us know which of these very talented high school dancers is moving forward and why.
Well, I have to say to you that Tyler and Sasha and I really had a hard time deciding because the talent is so wonderful at this level. And we really had a lot of back and forth because you all bring so much to the table. And we felt at this stage, because you're all great, and you're all going to have wonderful careers, for this moment in time, we would like the lovely Miss Ava to come along with us.
Ava Madara, dancing another day. Thank you so much to our judges, Sasha, Tyler, Phil. You're all fantastic. I only wish that high school dancer me could have had this kind of insight at my fingertips. It's amazing to watch them grow and be pushed. Congratulations to everybody moving on to our top five. And of course, to Ava as well. We'll be back next week, Thursday, October 1st. October 1st, how is that even possible? At 8 p.m. to announce who's making it into the top three and onto our grand finale. Be sure to follow Broadway World on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram to see when next round voting opens up to the public, which will be on Monday. I'm your Broadway buddy, Ben Cameron. Love you all, and we'll see you guys soon. Keep on dancing.
Bye.
Welcome back to Broadway World's Next on Stage.
Runaway. Romeo is calling for Juliet. Ready, set, Sam, you ready? Let's go anywhere. Say the word and I'm already there.
Papa, what you mean?
I just, I'm in shock how young all of you are. Like, I'm in shock that you're already this good.